Hey, what's up guys, Camp in Russia here. Welcome back everybody to another Fortnite video. Today we discuss tonight's update. We actually have patch notes for it. They're released already, so we'll discuss the changes coming in tonight's update. We're looking at a massive competitive announcement and a bunch of changes they're going to be making in-game, including some changes in tonight's update once again, and some stuff in between. Stick around. It's a big video. A bunch of news dropped today. You're not going to want to miss it. Also, touch that like button for me. Boom. I bribe you with a picture or a video of something cute. You hit the like button. Look at those eyes. Ladies and gentlemen, look at those eyes, right? You cannot hit the like button looking at that guy. Never gonna stop, ladies and gentlemen, never gonna stop, all right? We love this. We love this little tradition. Something's lurking in the jungle. Hunt or be hunted, the 15.21 update scheduled for release tomorrow, January 20th. Downtime will begin at approximately 4 a.m. Eastern. So I will be making a video tonight, no doubt. I'm staying up. It'll probably be one video. So just a quick reminder, subscribe to the channel. All right. I know there's about 39% of you watching that are not subscribed. So I just, even if I can convince 1%, all right, that number is going to look real big. Thanks for the support. Make sure you get here. Turn those noties on and we'll update you on everything happening tonight. I'm excited, man. It should be a good one. Here's the info we got. Fortnite status responded to itself saying 15.21 brings a new boss character plus mythic item, jungle hunter quests, and IO guards have been removed from arena. Okay, that makes me happy. I've not played much arena. But any chance I can avoid those IO guards, it should be a big update. Now, on top of that, Fortnite also tweeted, incoming transition, another reality log, target description, Yautja, trophy hunter. Let's play the audio.
Reality log, 2053, 105-28. I don't think my target knows that I know that he knows where I am, which is just where I want him, you know? He's been hunting me for my last dozen jumps, but it's table turning time. Because the cat in this little cat and mouse game, he doesn't know that the mouse has a knife. That's right. The hunter is now the hunted. I lost him. Well, it was nice being the hunter. If you need me, I'll be wallowing in mud. Again. But the moment I have the upper hand, it's welcome to the jungle.
That's a little creepy, man. I don't know. I got my headphones turned up right now, and that made me a little uncomfortable. I gotta be honest, but I love the reality logs. I love this, I don't know, this technique of teasing or whatever that they've taken on this season at the end of last. You know, again, Predator. We're talking about Predator. Here's a new portal picture that just got decrypted. So the portal in-game, you'll see this image floating around. Someone on Reddit posted, it's just some random, like, iStock Google photo. But whatever, I mean, it works perfectly. Also, just a reminder, Fortnite Creative. The creative team challenged the community to make games. Open world action adventure, social simulation, survival, job simulation, social deduction, tycoons. Basically trying to turn creative into more of a platform, right? This was announced a while ago. We talked about it in a video. I'll link it down below, but it's been extended. It's been extended from the 18th to January 25th. So you have about another week if you want to submit and try and get involved in that. Again, link down below for more info. All right, let's talk about the soccer skins. All right, there's a collab going on with Pele, the famous football soccer player. All right, we're just gonna go with soccer because Canada, that's what we call it here. I'm gonna go with soccer, all right? Don't trash me in the comments. I don't need to see it, man. I don't need to see it, I'm acknowledging. But yeah, so there's a collaboration going on. We'll talk about that in a second, but here are all the skins. There's a bunch of soccer skins with a ton of different character variations. I believe there's 10 different styles, 10 different separate skins you'll have the option to buy. These will be in the shop January 23rd. However, I've got all the new football skins in game now, HD playing in the background courtesy of HypeX while I talk about this. But however, you can win these 10, you get all 10 free skins if you're able to place high enough in a solo Pele tournament on January 20th, so tomorrow. Alright, I don't know if there's any going to be any special variations to the game mode or anything. It might just be straight, you know, Fortnite, competitive Fortnite. But that's happening tomorrow. And each outfit can be swapped to any of the 23 football clubs we've teamed with from around the globe. That includes Manchester, Los Angeles, Rangers FC, Sydney FC, and a bunch more. Again, post will be linked down below if you're curious. And then there's going to be a new emote called Pele's Air Punch emote. And I'm sure if you're a soccer fan, you know what that emote is, right? The legendary Air Punch. So that's going to be in the item shop as well. Also, top scorers in the Pele Cup will have the opportunity to win a customized signed shirt. All right, that's for the higher finishers. But yeah, I believe it's something like top 3,500 in solos. I don't know what region that is. Are going to win the 10 free skins, right? You don't just get one, you get all 10, which I think is pretty cool. So that's where we're at. There's also a football tournament in Fortnite Creative, something fun you can check out there as well. So more collaborations, random, but I think cool, man. I like that it's random. It's all over the place, and we get different, you know, such different cosmetics each time. I'm loving it. I'm definitely loving it. Flora's Lava LTM has just been added to the API. This image has. So the LTM will most likely return as a regular LTM in the next few days. Will it be Gref G or not? I hope we get both, man. Like, I loved Gref G. You guys know last video's gameplay was Gref G tournament, and it was a blast. Like, we had so much fun. However, I do miss the normal Flora's Lava too, right? Maybe with a couple more rotation items added in there. So it's not as easy to die, then it would be perfect. So I hope they have both, right? Because they called the Gref G Melt, the Melt LTM was the name of it when they accidentally released it public for a couple minutes. So hopefully they have two versions. We'll see. Should be coming in a few days here, though. Massive Chapter 2 Season 5 FNCS announcement. Esports is not dead in Fortnite. FNCS will have $20 million in prize money compared to $17 million in 2020. And format tweaks also after considering player feedback. So a lot of good in this post. We were just, last video before, we were just talking about the esports situation, where it's at, and some problems and complaints, and they've responded, man. They've responded big time. So yeah, they've went up in prize money. Now, here are the adjustments that they've made after listening to the community. Players will compete in a single cross-platform player pool. This allows players on multiple platforms to play together as teammates. Okay, that's a huge one. All right, and it doesn't split the prize money from console and PC. And I know that's going to make the try hard console players angry. I don't know, dude. I don't know if this is, you know, the best of the best. And I know PC has a huge advantage to console, but I guess that's the point, right? The PC is still going to beat a console player most of the time, if not all the time, when it's like the top console and the top PC, because console's limited to 60 frames per second and input lag, right? It's just such a disadvantage. And you know, the points to test the best of the best. So I like this change. I do. I know it's a controversial change, so I do want to hear your thoughts and opinions below, because I know some of you may disagree with me. Weekly qualifiers will have an additional round to pare down to the final lobby more gradually. See details below. Once qualified to the semis, teams will be locked and not be able to play in additional qualifiers. This means if a team directly qualifies to the semis in week one, that team will not be able to influence week two or week three qualifiers. Another big change, right? No griefing from a team who's already made it. That's a massive change. Semifinals and finals will be played out on separate weekends to better manage both player fatigue and tournament operations, right? A little quality of life for the players. Jeez, let them sleep, man, right? Let them eat. All prizes have been shifted to the finals. Okay, that's big too. The top three teams from each region's finals will auto-qualify for the next season's FNCS finals. This change requires that all three members of the team remain together during the season. Another big one for keeping organizations around, right? It's a sustainable model so the orgs can be confident in earning money each year, right? It's a big part of it. FNCS champions and other consistent top performers will earn the opportunity to be invited to the mid and end of year prize competition. So other prize competitions with more money in them if you do well here. And then there's slightly different scoring formats for single lobby versus multiple lobby gameplay to account for increased level of competition and the increased challenge of obtaining eliminations in the later stages. Here's our schedule. You can see it all there. Those finals are going to be fun to watch, man. If all the money is in the finals, that's just a lot at stake at one time. And I got to be honest, that's my favorite time to watch, right? When there's a bunch of money on the line, you know they're trying their absolute hardest. Tensions are high, emotions are high. It's going to be a blast. Here's the prize pool distribution by region. Of course, EU at the top, just basically based on population. Now, the final thing here that we're going to discuss, the rest you can read down below, competitive gameplay changes. The changes to competitive playlists before FNCS starts includes addition of the lever action shotgun, vaulted rift fish, vaulted shockwave grenades, removal of IO guards and elevators, that's tonight. Sand tunneling will remain in competitive playlists and tournaments as long as it remains in the core playlist, as it is a major feature of this season's map. We made adjustments to the amount of bars players started with in competitive playlists. We'll continue to monitor how the bar system fits in competitive, and we'll make adjustments as necessary. There's going to be more exclusive console competitions, and there's going to be trio cash cups every Monday now instead of every other, so people can practice more. That's all our info. I know a bit longer of a video, but that was a massive announcement, and they've responded to the esports complaints very well, in my opinion. Let me know your thoughts on anything we discussed today. Make sure to touch that like button for me on your way out. Code the Camp and Rusher in the item shop, especially for those new Pele skins, soccer skins, and let me know if you're using the code. Take care, everybody. Talk soon. I'll see you later tonight. Goodbye.